Champions matchup and some spectacular talent on your screen right now. Let's not waste any more time. Let's get down to the field for kickoff. The getting to know each other process is over. Time to get down to it, and we're off in week three of Draft Champions. Short kick here, fielded about the 17. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. On first down, it's long. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And it's a fumble. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might...
That's caught inside the 20. They got 29 yards there. And that's good for a Jet first down. So they're operating in the red zone. From the red zone now, Luck. That's complete, right around the 8. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. Mike Evans, a 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Jets have taken a first quarter lead. And he knocks it through. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Manning now on first down. And he hits Jason Witten, the tight end. He's at the 30. All the way in. Touchdown, New England. Jason Witten, 73 yards. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. And he puts it through. So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. Short kick here, fielded about the 17. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Here's the Jet offense now. They head out to take over. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counterpunch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. Two Patriots there to bring him down.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands that can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position. It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
They're going to go. It's Luck going for the deep ball. And that's caught inside the 30. It's a big-time play there on 4th and 10. 44 yards.
We know it's tough enough to pick up first downs on third down plays, but when you go for it on 4th down, sometimes you're actually just praying, and on that play, the prayer was answered.
They go play action here on 1st down. Oh, so close to an interception. Read that beautifully. Got his hands on it, couldn't get it. And it's second down.
Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
18 yards there, and it'll be a first and goal.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target. And he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups, and they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
And let's see, six defensive backs out there. They're in the dime here on third and goal. Luck now to throw, and he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
So much of this game is about leverage. We always talk about low man wins in the trenches. Well, it's like that at just about every position. And sometimes, if you lose that leverage and you're losing the battle, just jump up at the line of scrimmage and try and bat the ball away. And that's exactly what happened there.
Here's Luck. And it is incomplete. They had the play call on fourth and goal, but it's dropped. Starting field position here for the offense. Manning now on first down. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. Give him eight on the play, and it'll make it second down.
I think the best offenses love to get the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play. Funches with a catch over the middle. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. Looking for a seam but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Credit the tackle to Navarro Bowman. So second and 10 here. Now Manning throwing on second down. Looking for his running back, and he's got it. He showed off the athletic juke, but it didn't buy him a whole lot of real estate. It'll be a pickup of just two, and they're going to have a third down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Throwing is Manning on third down, and he gets it to Finch's complete. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
It'll go as a gain of 10 there, and that's good for a New England first down. They come out here in the eye. They'll run it now with Young, the fullback. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
And there's the pickup you want on first down. All offenses say, you get me four on first down, we'll take it. How about if you get five? They'll really be happy.
Manning to throw on second down. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. The man with over 1,000 catches, Jason Witten, the intended receiver. And it'll be third down. And on third and five, this will be the eighth play of the drive. They'll run it now with Smith. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave them with a fourth down. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. More from Minneapolis after this. And they're going to at least line up to go for it here on fourth down. throw for it on fourth. And this is incomplete. The Patriots come up empty on fourth down. And the Jets are going to get the football back. So out now come the Jets. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go-around?
I don't think it's
under pressure, and down he goes. Luck is sacked. They overload him that time with a safety blitz, and he winds up being dropped for a loss of seven. The throw on second down is locked. He's going to loft one deep left side here. That's caught inside the 20. And he's going to be taken down deep into Patriot territory.
As far as I'm concerned, Andrew Luck can do it all. I mean, he's an underrated runner, toughness in the pocket, strong and stout. But let's face it, the money, that comes from his arm.
And smart, valedictorian of his high school class in Houston that he goes to Stanford. He's got it all. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now.
Now, that's the defense that they were looking for, being able to get extra bodies to the point of attack to deal with the big guy carrying the ball. You really don't want to be in a position where it's a one-on-one tackle with him.
They keep it on the ground, but this time it's Murray. Give him right around four on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on third and goal. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Now Luck. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
On fourth down, Luck. And he's got his man in stride. Complete. And he's in. Touchdown, Jets. Joseph Fourier. From 3 yards out, and the Jets are able to strike for six. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And now out come the Patriots. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
And now they're in the hurry up.
That was a beautifully executed screen pass. Let the rushers get upfield. The blocking forms in front. Lofted it to the runner. And now, not only does he have open space in front of him, he's got an edge.
Weaving through traffic, and now he's free. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. A big play there. 50 yards. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up.
After nearly 30 minutes of football, that touchdown puts us in a position where if they make the extra point, we're right back to even before we start the second half.
Now it's Wilson. Fighting through. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. The New York set to take the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
He's going to launch this thing way downfield. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining. Second down now after the incompletion.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot.
He's got a man complete. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. On first down, it's Luck. Over the middle to Evans. And he's brought down after a good game. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So as they take it over, we step aside. And did it get there? Yes. Boy, he didn't get much of that at all. He tucked it just between the crossbar and the left upright.
Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Back-to-back one-yard runs here, so that leaves them with a third down and eight.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws.
And now the ball comes out. Manning lost it. And it's scooped up by the Jets. And he takes it to the house. It's a fumble recovery for a Jet touchdown.
This was a close game. They needed a little breathing room. Boy, they got it right there on that return for a touchdown.
Yeah, we would say that this could be huge. Forget it. It was huge. Gave them a comfortable lead.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. Fielded about a yard deep. Turn here, he gets it out to the 25-yard line.
So the Patriots coming out now.
Manning now on first down. And this one complete to Witten over the middle. And he's brought down. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
Just what you want on a first down run, call it 8 yards, and it's second and two. Manning to throw on second down. And this is going to be incomplete.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
The Jets will bring in a nickel set as they try to stop this third down. Throwing now is Manning. Complete to Jason Witten. It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
Oftentimes we think of those tough yards as grinding yards that a running back has to pick up. How about the tight end there picking up the first down in that situation?
That's what he's there for, right?
Big fella, get it to him. Let him fight off some people and pick up the necessary yardage.
And some room to maneuver. And he is out of bounds inside the 35.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
And nearly picked off there, and it would have been a great time for their first pick. Instead, it's second down. Inside give. This is the fullback, Young. And he's brought down. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs. So here we go, first and 10 now.
I know a lot of times we like to put players in certain boxes. He does this and he does that. But this guy, he can do a little bit of everything. He's not just a lead blocker or a guy who protects the passer. Handing the ball, he might want to get out of the way.
And eventually brought down, but it's near the 5 at the 6. In the red zone this time.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
And again, this time to the tailback. And he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
No gain on that run. And while this team is down, they're not out of it by any stretch of the imagination. Maybe you just have to think about different style of running in order to get this guy going.
To throw is Manning. And this is caught. Touchdown, Patriots. Devin Funchess. A 5-yard touchdown. And the Patriots are back within a score. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route ordinarily is probably about 3 steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it was a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. And that should give his guys a spark. He's up all the way to the 44-yard line. Now the Jets offense gets ready to head back on the field. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
On second down, here's Love. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. And the offense lining up first and 10.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Two Patriots there to bring him down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
If they want a first, they need to get the football to the 32 here on third down. Throwing on third down. Luck. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. And let's see what the defensive coordinator may have up his sleeve here to try to get this final last stand and win this football game. So after the INT, it's Manning. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. They'll give him 8 on the play, and that'll make it second down. And, of course, the quarterback in this situation, he's realizing time is becoming a factor. Let's see if they can get some points on the board here late. Now Manning throwing on second down. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he's brought down. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
On first and 10, here's Manning. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Offense staying ahead of the chains here, 2nd and 3. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues. Fresh set of downs here.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
And a neutral zone infraction on the defense.
The defense thought they had the timing count on the quarterback's cadence, but they jumped too soon.
So a first down and 5 for the offense. They'll look to throw. Oh, no, lost the football. And it's scooped up by the Jets. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. The Jets offensive unit ready to get going here. They have the 3-point lead. Defense did their job. Now, late game. Although it looks good, you know the coaches, they haven't counted this as a victory yet.
I agree with you totally. Big applause for the defense, but no one is taking their headset off on the sidelines. They don't believe this game is over. The offense has to close this one out by taking care of the football.
And they'll try to close it out now. Throwing now, Luck. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. It's Clay Matthews with a pick. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. And last time, the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard. Had a drive going and pushed it past the 50-yard line so they thought they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? He's back to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And a big 32-yard play on third.
After that nice game there, for the rest of the game, the defense is going to have to respect the running backs as passing threats as well. Not just play them strictly to run the football. They may be able to get downfield and catch it, too.
And now a first down following that long game. Back to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Henry Anderson in there to take him down, and the clock will roll.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense, so he kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
He'll look to throw. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. 7 yards on the play, and that'll make it third and goal.
It didn't check off every box, but the most important one, got the clock stopped, getting out of bounds. It may be a little short of the first down, but I thought that was the key.
Back to throw. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. So in the final minute, they turn it over to their kicker to get him back to even, and he does not disappoint.
Brandon, do you think the pressure ever gets to this guy? Because I sure don't. That was pretty smooth right there. But I tell you, he better not rest on his laurels, because there's a good chance they may need him again if this game goes to overtime.
Now the Jet offense about to take over as they head out onto the field. They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range. Not much. A tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out. Get the
now a hit and Lock lost the football. It's out. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So they almost turn it over there. Scary moment. Second down here. They'll come out in the pistol. Back to throw. Love. He's going to air one out. And got his man. Complete. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
Now it's Wilson. And he breaks it all the way out to the 38-yard line. Great return. And New York set to take the field. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game, because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition. Let's face it now, the ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
Yeah, as we said, they control their own destiny now. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
It's caught at the 10. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air, because right now we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's two touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that in the podcast.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL.